right? So these are the changing expectations which has made the supply chain. We are talking a lot about supply chain. Why? What is the role of supply chain? Because we will consider, right, we would be considering a company or an environment where an organization would be buying from suppliers. So both have very important role. Hence, you know, we must have a good knowledge on or the lens of supply chain, right? So this strategic sourcing course, we are dealing through the lens of supply chain, right? Where two entities, industrial purchasing, would be focused, right? And everyone should be aware of that, you know, supply chain is nothing but starting from the raw material, Mother Earth, to the final consumer. And in this supply chain, the real value enters only when the ultimate customer buys a product, right? Supply systems play a important role. Why it should actually be called supply network? Because supply chain is a kind of intertwined, you know, stakeholders involved, right? Which actually should be viewed as a single entity here, right? But it has its own challenges to be considered as single entity, right? But it is viewed as supply networks, right? Where every entity in the supply chain must focus on ultimate customer, right? And we should be, the other lens of supply chain, why this lens of supply chain is important, that because it is very well said, supply chain is as strong as the weakest link in the supply chain, isn't it? So if I am a company manufacturing, converting anything, even if I am a services company, I'm dependent on tier one, my immediate supplier, tier two, the supplier to tier one, and so on. Right? So even if one of the entity fails, it would have ripple effect, you know. That's why the weakest link in the supply chain decides the strength of supply chain. Okay? So we need to take this lens, we need to take this broad concept in mind, the concept of supply chain, then we would be able to understand better the strategic sourcing. And it is also called extended enterprise. Like, you know, we have seen an example of Dell where they are emphasizing on virtual integration, that group of network or firms who collaborate in partnership fashion, they are also called extended enterprise, right? So now we have actually spoken about the changing environment, why we have moved from purchasing procurement functions to a strategic sourcing aspect, what has made those changes, okay? Now, what some companies have done, right? Why some companies have moved from procurement to strategic sourcing? This is very well discussed in this paper called Procurement as Strategy, right, by Carlos. So I would recommend, like, you know, all of you to read and go through that paper, right? And we would see that, you know, what different initiatives companies have taken, right, to adopt strategic sourcing, right? So now we will read that. Yes. So I hope you have read the paper, right? So what is your views, like, you know, let's jot down, right? Just raise your hands. So we will note down what is your views, right? And then we would try to clarify. So who would go first? So what is a changing perspective? What is the new thing you could find, like, you know, after reading this thing? You can cite an example of a company and state what is your observation? Maybe some striking thing?
It's mentioned like HP is co-designing the items with the supply chain partners. So that was like, I feel like new thing.
Yes. So co-designing, okay, this is something which was missing in the traditional concepts of purchasing procurement, co-designing the product, right? So this is one thing, you know, changing perspectives of co-designing. We can have another one.
Even Boeing, they are given an example that capital intensive companies like Boeing, they are outsourcing the entire, not just the subcomponent, but the entire subsection itself of fabrication. And they're willing to share their designs and fabrication, new jet designs as well, with their subsection supply partners, so that they can reduce their costs.
Yes, so this is, they are going for complete
subsection outsourcing.
Complete subsection, right? They have, like, you know, it's not only outsourcing, but outsourcing of parts to outsourcing of complete subsection. Okay, so this is more and more reliance, like, you know, on outsourcing, right? And suppose when it comes to outsourcing the design part, you can see how crucial it is and how important it would be then to go for, you know, this partnership and collaboration with such outsourced partners. You can have one more observation. Yeah.
They mentioned about the survey with procurement executives. So, like, recently 90% said, like, most of the work has been changed, like, they have more responsibility on innovation and those stuffs,
exactly,
rather than just procurement activities.
Yes, so more responsibilities in terms of innovation, right? They have to keep innovating, right? Innovation and cycle time reduction, right? So cycle time reduction. So, cycle time reduction has to be in congruence with the suppliers, right? So, you would see that, you know, the companies like Adidas, or if they are sponsor of some sports league, right? So, one could see that, you know, how such companies, you know, all sportswear companies like Adidas, Nike or similar companies, they have to continuously, like, you know, following up with, you know, the series. Who would win, who would be the runners up, right? And accordingly, they have to, you know, introduce their merchandise. But, you know, whether it would be the winning team, who would win, one can see that, you know, this is a marketing aspect. No doubt it is a marketing aspect, right? But mind it, like, you know, those products, right? Unexpectedly, some team winning last minute, right? We could reach to the market with the merchandise of winning team, but just see what is the supply chain behind it. How, you know, the whole supply chain made an effort to bring that product, right, which was involved in a lot of uncertainty, they have managed to bring that product to the market, right? This is only possible if, you know, suppliers are collaborating to produce, you know, to design, you know, to dye the merchandise, or, you know, to assemble the merchandise in quick time, right? Yes, we can have one more observation. Yes.
NPTEL engineers have partnered with the procurement teams to find ways to save costs in assembly.
Yes. So, when given an opportunity to the suppliers, right, given an opportunity to suppliers to come up with some innovative ideas, right, I'm talking about a company buying from their suppliers, right, inviting suppliers, right, to give ideas how with the use of the supplied products they can reduce the cost, right? Because the product which suppliers are supplying, the suppliers are specialized and expert of this products. They know what are the potential uses. They know how we can introduce innovation in that, which can eventually impact the bottom line of their buyer's company, right? So now you see here, this vision has to be there for probably this strategic sourcing function and department of that company to collaborate with their supplier. right? So this is what very important changing perspectives now we have learned with real life examples, like, you know, how they are changing, right? So we will move now, right? So from the changing expectations, from the examples point of view, like, you know, what leading companies do, right? Leading companies, they, right, they create new competition, right? Keep on searching new suppliers and developing alternatives, right? So they have gone from sole sourcing to a more coordinated way of sourcing, right? Consider sourcing procurement as agent of innovation, right? Design product to cost, right? How we can reduce the cost, how we can bring the new one. Tap supply knowledge for new and improved products, right? So this is how strategic sourcing, like, you know, is viewed in today's era. Okay, from now we have seen that, you know, in one example how it has impacted the bottom line. Yeah, we can take up a question. Yeah, yeah, can you give the mic? Yeah, yeah. So sole sourcing, sometimes, like, you know, we have monopolies, right? There is only a single supplier or only supplier who is capable of, you know, providing the material. Okay, down the line in this course we would see that every organization has different types of requirements, right? Starting from nut bolts to computers, from stationary to engines and more complex, like, you know, sub assemblies. Okay, so we cannot go for same kind of strategy for each and every product. So that's why first key components, sometimes the components which are very valuable to a company, probably more innovative component which is provided by a single source or very few suppliers are making, right? So what companies are doing, if it is a key component, if it is a valuable component, right, can we go for sole sourcing in a coordinated way, right? Can I innovate with the supplier, can I collaborate with the supplier to bring out that innovation or innovative thing, or maybe, you know, help in reducing the cost, right, for the key components. Okay, right. So we have seen, like, you know, examples that, you know, how the suppliers can actually help in innovation and help in reducing the cost. The cost is only one aspect, right? We would otherwise say that, see that how strategic sourcing and can impact any organization performance. There are few definitions of strategic sourcing where I would emphasize on one thing. Mostly we have discussed the important points, like here strategic sourcing view is to maximize the value of externally procured goods and services. Whatever activities, whatever goods or services we are buying, the strategic sourcing perspective says that we should do that to maximize the value. The old perspective is, you know, to focus only on the price, right? Good quality products, but main focus would be the price, right? So the focus should not be only the price of the product, but to maximize the value of externally procured goods and services, right? So again, even this example says which add maximum value to the buyers. So these are the activities, like to develop, qualify and employ suppliers which would maximize the value. We have, you know, other things, like, you know, which we would be doing down the line. We will learn the concept of total cost of ownership, which actually says that it is not only the purchasing price, which is not only the price, but when I am going to convert as a buyer, when buyer is going to convert the product, and after converting, how to dispose the disposal, like, you know, after finished good has gone to the market. So this three stages has to be considered while making the decision of buying the product. So this we will learn in detail later, right? But this term has come, I have just introduced this term. So strategic sourcing involves in whether this activities should be outsourced or not. When we will deal with outsourcing, we would learn that what are the apt conditions one should outsource, how we can capture total cost of ownership, how we can bring, you know, IT systems and e-thinking in the procurement. Very important thing, data-driven supply market research, right? Good strategic sourcing function, you know, they dedicate a team which continuously look for good supply market. Just like we do market research in the marketing side, there is a supply market research required to be updated with who are the good players, new innovative players coming in the market. So this is the quick definition of strategic sourcing. Some companies, Dell, I have already discussed, you know, Walmart has, you know, like, you know, they are achieved, you know, total system cost approach because their sustainable supplier relationship, right? And utilizing the relationships, they were able to, like, provide the low price products to the customers. General Electric, Motorola, these companies were pioneer of introducing e-reverse auctions, right? So that, you know, one can have price discovery. Price discovery means the best price for the product. So we will discuss all that. Today's lecture is more of an overview of what is going to come in the coming sessions.